My esteemed brothers, sister judges, Sri C.P. Sudhara Prasad, the Learned Advocate General, Sri Thomas Abraham, the President of the Kerala High Court Advocates Association, Sri K.K. Ravindranath, the Learned Additional Advocate General, Sri Sohan, the State Attorney, Sri Suganapalan, the President of the Kerala High Court Senior Advocates Association, Srimati S.K. Devi, the President of the Kerala Federation of Women Lawyers, Sri Ajit Kumar, the Registrar General in Charge, ladies and gentlemen. We have assembled here to mourn the sad demise of Sir Justice Mohan M. Shantanagowda, a sitting judge of the Supreme Court of India and a former Chief Justice of this court. He left for his heavenly abode on 24/4/2021 while undergoing treatment at Medanta Medicity, Gurugram. His sudden demise is a shocking news to all in the legal fraternity and to his friends. Justice Shantanagowda was born on 5/5/1958 to Advocate M.C. Shantanagowda and Srimati Indira Shantanagowda at Kandeberg village in Haveri district of Karnataka. He enrolled as an advocate on 5/9/1980 and after a brief spell of practice in Dharwad under Higher Gowda, he joined the chambers of Advocate Sri Shivaraj V. Patil, as he was then, who later became a judge of the Honorable Supreme Court of India. During his illustrious career, he served as vice chairman and then as chairman of Karnataka Bar Council. His lordship had also served as a state public prosecutor of Karnataka State from 1999 to 2002. He was appointed as additional judge of High Court of Karnataka on 12/5/2003 and was appointed a permanent judge on 24/9/2004. He assumed the office of the acting Chief Justice of this court on 1/8/2016. He had sworn in as the Chief Justice on 22/9/2016. And was elevated to the Supreme Court on 17/2017. In the full court reference on his assumption of office as the Chief Justice of this court, while making the reply speech, he quoted Confucius thus: "Living is very simple, loving is also simple, laughing is too simple, winning is also simple, then what is difficult? Being simple is very difficult. But I must say that the said difficulty was seen simplified by him, and he lived his life simply. He was sober, sagacious, and his sound knowledge in criminal law reflected in the very recent decision in Bhima Rasu Prasad versus State, reported in 2021-1 KLD 550. His lordship carefully and cautiously drew the difference between sections 195(1)(b)(1) and 191(1)(b)(2) of the Code of Criminal Procedure. In the decision in Amitabh Das Gupta versus Union of India, 2021-1 KLT online 1019, Supreme Court, while dealing with the Consumer Protection Act 2019, he held that banks are service providers of a separate duty to care to exercise due diligence in maintaining and operating their locker and safety deposit systems, and it includes ensuring the proper functioning of a locker system, guarding against unauthorized access to the lockers, and providing appropriate safeguards against theft and robbery. Furthermore, it was held the banks, as custodians of public property, cannot leave the customers in the lurch merely by claiming ignorance of the contents of the lockers. He was the 9th senior most judge of the Supreme Court. His lordship was to retire only on 4/5/2023. With his death, we lost a well-mannered, a well-informed, a well-balanced, and above all, a well-born, simple, beloved man. We joined the bereaved family in their sorrow, and on behalf of my companion justices, and on my own behalf, and also on behalf of the staff of this court, I extend hearty condolence to the family. May his soul rest in peace."
Honorable Mr. Justice C.T. Ravikumar, other Honorable Judges on the dais, President of the Kerala High Court Educators Association, Thomas Abraham, President of the Kerala Federation of Women Lawyers, Ms. Srimadhi S.K. Devi, Senior Standing Counsel for the Government of India Taxes, Ms. P.K. Ravindranath Menon, Law Officers of the Central and State Governments, esteemed members of the Bar, Registrar General and other Registrars, and members of the staff of the High Court, members of the staff of the Office of the Advocate General, President of the members of the Kerala High Court Advocates Clerks Association, ladies and gentlemen. It was with heavy hearts and excruciating feeling of grief that we came to know the sad demise of Honorable Mr. Justice M. Chandanagowda, a sitting judge of the Supreme Court and a former Chief Justice of the Honorable Court. He was 63. It was reported that he was ailing for some time, but the end came unexpectedly. Now it is our painful realization that that benevolent, loving and affable personality, with his ever-smiling face, calm, quiet and gentle, with his eyes reflecting and a ruminating mind, will hereafter be with us only in our memory. The gorgeous days spent with us, deeply engaged in solving many legal conundrums, discussing with and debating on different and diverse facets of law, the cultural revolution of the nation and the people, etc., are still fresh in our memory. It was in February 2017 that he left us to adorn the coveted prestigious post of Judge of the Supreme Court. And now the cruel hands of destiny has snatched away him from us with more than 2 years' service yet left for him in the Appeals Court. It was an irony of fate that agonizing task of making this obituary address has fallen me, who was the then Advocate General of the State, had the opportunity to deliver the welcome speech on the occasion of the assumption of Mr. Chief Justice of this Court on 23rd September 2000, and also the farewell speech when he left us on his elevation to the Supreme Court. Justice M. Chandanagowda was born on 5/5/1958, son of Mr. M.C. Chandanagowda and Srimadhi Indira Chandanagowda, at Kandabagur village in Haveri district, Karnataka. After obtaining his law degree from Karnataka University, he enrolled as an advocate in Karnataka State Bar Council in 1980. He had an illustrious and eventful career at the bar, and which earned him the renown and repute of a brilliant and versatile lawyer. In recognition of his outstanding merits, he was elevated as an additional judge of the High Court of Karnataka on 12/5/2003, and as a permanent judge on 24/24/2004. His career as a judge of the High Court of Karnataka for 13 years was epoch-making. Laurels and acclaim came to be showered on him for the meritorious and unique performance he made on the bench, delivering landmark judgments, embracing different and diverse branches and fields of law. Equipped with a razor for sharp intellect, perfected by deep learning, wider vision and amazing analytical skill, he could solve intricate and confusing legal problems and conundrums effortlessly and effectively. After a glorious and eventful career as a judge of the Karnataka High Court, he was transferred to the High Court of Karnataka, and he assumed the office of Chief Justice of this court on 23/9/2016. From then, hardly six and a half months, he had been with us as a Chief Justice when he was appointed as a Judge of the Supreme Court of India. On such appointment, he left us on 15 February 2017 to adorn the exalted office of Judge of the Supreme Court of India. Justice Chandanagowda was a man of immaculate character, vast erudition and noble learning. Illustrious was his career at the Bar, profoundly spectacular and impressive was his functioning as a bench. With his juridical erudition and deep learning, complemented by his innate integrity and independence, he carved out for him a unique personality with only a very few parallels in the Indian judiciary. He commanded the esteem and adoration of the bench and bar alike, and also the other luminaries in the legal world. with magnificent qualities of his head and heart. He was brilliant and versatile, and both as a judge and as a lawyer, he left scarcely any branch of law untouched. He had great respect and admiration for the age-old, time-tested intellectual, ethical, and spiritual values of India, which have synthesized in evolving what may be called Indian cultural heritage. His understanding of the profound vision of culture and law, which runs through the entire text and theme of the Indian Constitution, can be gathered from his highly instructive and marvelous judgments. He ardently believed in, and while on the bench, passionately endeavored to transform into reality what Toynbee said, that law is intended to be imposed, impartiality, and to be enforced effectively upon all and sundry who come with us with its ambit. He also believed that law has to respond to the social changes, and has also to perform a constructive and positive function as instrument of social change. That attitude of his reflects in the words of Sri Aurobindo, who in his celebrated work, India's Rebirth, tersely stated, "Never lose sight of the truth of law, truth that law was made for the man and man and not man for the law." He admired the universal vision of composite cultural heritage of India. His working faith and abiding belief were deeply rooted in the principles of unity, secularism, and democracy. As Chagla said, so secularism for him was an attitude of the mind and the quality of the heart. Bestowed with a powerful intellect and unbending moral values, he always kept an uninhibited mind, dared to express his views unconcerned about the critical comments and sharp disagreements from whatever quarters it may be. Several judgments penned by him have legendary dimensions. Many of the landmark judgments he has handed down while in the bench of the high courts and in Supreme Court. Due to the constraints of time, I am not attempting to chronicle them. The cases of Indore Development Authority versus Shailendra, Kandaru Rajivudu versus Indian Young Lawyers Association, popular notes of Sabarimala case, and Ambigaba Das Gupta versus Union Bank of India are some such to be cited few. Apart from being an outstanding lawyer and a highly erudite and efficient judge, he was a warm human being whose life is morally inspirational. He was a versatile personality, uniquely secular. As a judge, he illumined justice and humanized the law. He was more than a great judge, a perfect human being. His was a life of realization, a life of attainments, a life of rare achievements. Only very, very rarely do come across such lives whose prime concerns was the betterment of the society and the upliftment of the weaker sections. The sad demise of Justice Mohanam Chandragowdar is a great loss not only to the legal world but also social life of this country as well. It will take long years to fill the void created by his departure. On these moments of bereavement, we, the lawyer fraternity of the state as a whole, pay our respectful homage to the departed soul. On this occasion, we also share the grief of the members of this buried family.
Honourable Ms. Justice C.T. Ravikumar, other Honourable Judges, Advocate General Mr. C.P. Sudhayana Prasad, Additional Advocate General Mr. K.K. Ravindranath, State Attorney Mr. K.V. Sohan, Sri Ajit Kumar, Registrar General in Charge and other officers of this court, Advocate Clerks and dear friends. Today I stand before you as a representative of a bar in deep grief. Robert, an avid member of our fraternity, has left us, but only after etching very warm memories in our minds. We have lost an ever-glowing star in our legal arena. A loss which can never be compensated is what has occurred to the legal fraternity by the sad death of His Lordship Justice Shantanu Gowda. I am sure that His Lordship's loss would inflict a deep and painful injury in the hearts of all persons who had at least one chance of meeting and interacting with His Lordship. In 2017, I had numerous such occasions as the president of this association. He played a crucial role in overcoming the problems faced by this court, which developed consequently the tussle between a section of the press and the members of the legal fraternity. It started in 2016 and continued in 2017 also. But His Lordship's balanced approach paved way for overcoming the turmoil. Judicial temperament has been described as reflecting patience, open-mindedness, courtesy, tact, courage, punctuality, firmness, understanding, compassion, humility, and common sense, unquote. Justice Shantanu Gowda displayed these virtues in abundance. He was an incarnation of all good qualities essential for a judge. Those of us who had the privilege to meet him will remember him as a model of independence, non-partisan comity, graciousness, and good humor. Quick and incisive in his mind, as his mind was, he also had a healthy dose of common sense and never lost sight of fairness and justice. Ordinarily, when one takes the bench, one becomes less involved than previously with the various concerns of the legal profession. But this is not true of Justice Shantanu Gowda. Recalling the sad plight of a lawyer on whose death his hapless family could not even manage the funeral expenses, His Lordship, who was instrumental in giving impetus for starting welfare fund activities in Karnataka state, displayed keen interest in the welfare fund trust formed by our High Court Association as well. Another indelible memory is when I had occasion to enjoy his friendship's hospitality and warmth while attending a meeting of the Southern State Bar Councils at Bangalore as a member of the Kerala State Bar Council, while His Lordship was the chief host, as he held the office of the chairman of the Bar Council of Karnataka then. Justice Shantanu Gowda understood the law and the court's role as its keeper. He was passionate about his beliefs and always courageous in defending them. But he never forgot how important it is for a judge to have a measure of humility. He listened and considered other points of view. He was not afraid to change his mind or be bent when he thought it was right to do so. Justice Shantanu Gowda was equally unafraid to stand firm. He was decisive when he needed to be. On the rare occasion when the court did not agree and Justice Shantanu Gowda was in the minority, he wrote dissents that were informative and straight to the point. His Lordship, within a year of being elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court, fearlessly pointed out in the Indore Development Authority case the impropriety of the bench overruling a precedent laid down by a coordinate bench, noting that the proper course would be to refer the matter to a larger bench. Ultimately, the matter was referred to a larger bench. In several leading cases which came before the bench, enriched with His Lordship's presence, the judgments doubtlessly revealed the bold judge in him, that the welfare of the farmers of the country was very much in His Lordship's mind was evident from the judgment rendered in Mrs. Nandan Biometrics versus Ambiga Devi, wherein it was held that a farmer was entitled to file a consumer complaint against a seed company for deficiency of service. His Lordship took the view that the buying of a seed by a farmer cannot be categorized as one of commercial purpose. In Leelavati Kirtilal Mehta Medical Trust versus Mrs. Unique Shanti Developers, Justice Shantanu Gowda held that the provision of hostel facilities to nurses so as to facilitate better medical care is a positive duty enjoined upon the hospital. In High Court of Judicature at Madras versus M.C. Subramanian, a bench led by His Lordship held that parties to settle their cases through private mediation outside the boards contemplated under Section 89 of the civil procedure code also are entitled to get refund of court fees. An accused, irrespective of the merits of the case against him, should be granted default or compulsive bail if the investigating agency does not complete the probe within the prescribed time limit. Held a bench comprising of Justice Chandragowda in M. Davidan versus the Intelligence Officer, Director of Revenue Intelligence. In Krishnalal Chawla versus State of Uttar Pradesh, Justice Chandragowda observed the trial courts and magistrates are the first line of defense for a harassed and distraught litigant and have as much responsibility as the Supreme Court, if not more, in safeguarding fundamental rights of citizens. Death is an inevitable part of life, and every one of us has to reconcile with this reality. Loss of men of eminence like Justice Chandragowda makes me recollect the meaningful lines of a Malayalam poem which depicts the certainty of the end of every human being being born on earth because his wisdom, wealth and knowledge. Mary John Thorndike Prashastamaya Logavayatra in the Kavidil Nadi Nalivi. Samarthanaya Caesarum, Prasithanaya Homerum, സമത്വമറ്റ സോളമൻ തുടങ്ങിയുള്ള വിജ്ഞരും അമർന്നുപോയി കാലചക്ര വിഭ്രമത്തിലെങ്കിലേ നമുക്ക് പിന്നെ എന്ത് ശങ്ക, മാറ്റമൊന്നുമില്ലതിൽ. ദ പോയറ്റ് സേസ്, ഇഫ് ഗ്രേറ്റ് മെൻ ലൈക്ക് ഏബിൾ സീസൺ ആൻഡ് ഫേമസ് ഹോമർ ആൻഡ് സോളമൻ ഹു ഹാഡ് നോ ഈക്വൽസ് ഹാഡ് ഓൾ ബീൻ ക്രഷ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദ ടേണിംഗ് ഓഫ് ദ വീൽ ഓഫ് ടൈം വെൻ വൈ ഷുഡ് ബി ഹാവ് എനി ഡൗട്ട് അവർ ഫേറ്റ് വിൽ ഓൾസോ ബി ദ സെയിം. ദിസ് ട്രൂത്ത് ഗീവ് സൊലേസ് ഇൻ ദ പെയിൻഫുൾ മൊമെന്റ്സ് ഓഫ് എവറി ഡിപ്പാർച്ചർ. The memories of Justice Chandragowda is certain to overcome the barriers of time. To live in the hearts we leave behind is not to die. May I request Your Lordship, Mr. Justice C.T. Devikumar, to direct the Registry of this court to convey our heartfelt condolences to the bereaved family. Thank you.
As a mark of respect to the departed soul, we shall now stand in silence for 2 minutes. The registry shall convey the condolence message of the bar and the bench to the members of the bereaved family. The judicial work of the High Court shall stand suspended till 11 a.m. today.